Stick Star Productions, Anthony Crimmins, joined by Coach Mike Galvin. We're settling in here for the second half of what has been a very entertaining and apropos second matchup, rematch of these two teams. The first time they met, SMU won by a bucket or two at most. And right now, A&M is enjoying a first half lead. Coach, what have you seen in the first half?
Well, number one, first and foremost, we've seen A&M really dominate the faceoff X, and they're dominating the pace of the game because of it. SMU really wants to take the air out of the ball and try and possess as much as they can, and A&M's making that really tough on them. They're putting them in a situation where they're not used to playing a whole lot of defense. They're not really getting to dominate the ball like they want to, and it'll be interesting to see if A&M can keep that up. And if SMU is going to stick with pressuring on the ball. Another inside roll, big save by Connolly, and we got a trash man finishing early.
So, on that one, Hepting carries up, gets under, initial save, rebound, lefty, picks it up, number 10, Steven Sattler, garbage goal.
And that's a tough one for Connolly because he's been seeing a couple of those inside rolls, finally made a great, great save, predicted where the guy was going, and there's just no way he's getting there in time for that rebound.
Those ones are demoralizing.
They really are. They really are, especially when you're a goalie. That's kind of one where you look at your teammates and say, hey, I'm going to need some help here because I can't do it all.
Another big faceoff win. Levi Jobe has been sensational.
He really has. He really has, and he set the tone for this entire team. Got a little bit of a mismatch here. Looks to shoot.
Can't throw it at a good goalie's feet.
Nope. And with the amount of quality looks they've gotten, you'd think they'd learn by now. This isn't the kind of goalie that you're going to shoot from the outside and get a lot of success with.
I'm going to really try if I'm a shooter, and here we go. They got a little transition here. If I'm getting that one, I'm going to try and throw that one as hard as I can off the chalk. You know, we've kind of warmed him up down low a little bit.
Yep.
Maybe bait him into thinking we're going low again. Get that thing to jump up right off the turf. Throw our hands from distance. They're just, you know.
And if they're not moving him laterally, he's not only going to save it, but he's catching that, and he's going to start fast breaks the other way.
SMU trying to get a little garbage of their own.
Getting physical on the inside. I think we're going to get a push on A&M here.
That's fine. It's all about the next play right now for Bryce Green. He, there's a little contact in there. This is a good matchup defensively. It's two big guys. Right now, it's just interesting watching A&M's two-slide situation. They are not inside out with their midi up top, which is leaving the skip lane wide open, especially if they get a two slide.
Here's got another inside roll. Big save.
Huge save. Took that one off the board. Oh, right there. If I'm Bryce Green, I'm trying to knock him right into the turf. That's a pretty good job defensively.
Oh, great shot.
I think Marco would probably like to have that one back. He was on that one.
I agree. And I think that's something we're going to see some from SMU a little bit more. A&M seems to be really trying to hesitate on these slides so that they're not giving up too much on the crease. SMU is probably just going to have to look to take their man one-on-one and get a shot with their hands free.
And that's a save being made on the opposite side, which possibly could have resulted in a bucket. And now it goes the other way, and SMU's able to convert. Big faceoff right here. Levi Jobe again. Big ground ball.
We got a 50-50 ball. Looks like SMU's going to come up with it.
I think if I'm SMU, I'm probably going to try and make an adjustment at the faceoff X. I might even double pull it just so that we can scrap it up. Levi Jobe had the faceoff win there. Got it to his wing guy. Didn't do a good enough job establishing the position on that.
And I think that's a great idea, too, because, I mean, he's really putting it wherever he wants. So I would stick my wing guys right with theirs and just have them try to play the ball 50-50.
Here's Garrett Cantrell. He's got a short stick matchup. He's going to want to.
Yeah, he's going to look to take advantage of this right away. Watch him to roll back to that left hand. Great defense by the Aggies.
That's one of those
push the other way.
That's one of those situations where one of the things that we look to stress with our attackmen is once you get that short stick matchup, you don't have to go right away. Let's go ahead and take it to where we're comfortable, make sure that we clear somebody out, and then attack the matchup appropriately. He just kind of went at it.
That's exactly right. And just because you have a good matchup doesn't mean it's going to go away if you hold on to the ball for a couple seconds.
Over and back. That is a bad, bad turnover.
Looks like it was one of the rare instances where SMU's pressure really got to the other team. And he better get his head up because he's got pressure coming his way. All of SMU's
that hit him right in the stick. What a terrible call.
Yeah. SMU's going to look to attack right away. Big save.
Big save. Number 11, he's the guy who made the play there defensively, created the turnover, and then created the opportunity. This is why every possession matters. What does your shot look like on a possession? Is it a turnover? We get a touch. We're kind of loose with the ball around the midfield line. And now SMU is on man up looking to tie the game.
That's a good find on the inside. And that's exactly what they want right there. They want to grab a bunch of attention with their shooters up top and see if they can get a skip and something easy on the inside. A&M's going to have to tighten that up. Maybe even try to get on these feeders' hands, make it a little tougher for them so they can't just dissect them so easily.
That was number 15, old Nicholas Gray. He got to the middle, moved the goalie off the near side pipe, and finished. Is that a delay?
Looks like we have – I don't think it was long enough to be a delay. I'm thinking we maybe have an unsportsmanlike of some type.
Nobody's in the penalty box right now.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Good job showing there. Just like that, that's a big turnover.
Oh, and that was off the pipe.
That's a good job of establishing position.
He really put the ref in a tough position. He kind of had to make that call.
Head up.
He's going right away.
Yeah, they're trying to pick the pace up.
Oh, big save. I think he got a piece of that one. Oh, we got a lot of contact.
This ref is getting into the game right here.
Oh, is he going to blow the whistle? There we go. Yeah, he certainly is.
Illegal body check.
I don't know if that check was too egregious. I think what we had happen there is he just left his feet and never really a good idea in the game of lacrosse.
No. Nope, I would agree. Now, here's an opportunity for A&M to respond. Game is tied. A&M had their largest lead of the game, finishing one out of the initial opportunity, out of their initial possession, and then SMU strikes back. Here they go. They're looking to push this bottom corner. They bring that man to the side.
Ooh,
oh, my.
Wow. One of the rare low-angle finishes that we've seen on Connolly today. That was a great lefty stick.
Tyler Kimball has really done a good job for A&M on that lefty wing. What they did was they pushed from X. Backside defenseman, he was the man who was playing the guy carrying from X because they didn't want to slide from that ball side defenseman up to Hepting. They swung the ball back through X. So now he's still engaged on that man carrying from X. They moved it to the shooting spot, not ready to rotate over the top. And he buries it.
Well, and they seem to have set a formula for how they want to score. They want to push from X. They want to have their shooters with their hands ready to shoot and see if they can get something easy because they know they're going to have a good look to beat this goalie. Another good faceoff. First part of this quarter really seemed to be more type of pace that SMU wants to play. And we got Robertson putting on a show here. That's a good no call by the referee. Another case of leaving your feet going in it in the wrong way. And I believe SMU is going to get called for not allowing 5 yards of space off the whistle.
I don't think they're used to this. I think that they are, you know, we'll see how the game ends up. But it's just interesting to watch. It's all about body language, sports fans, believe it or not. And right now, the defenseman's talking to him. His palms are up, you know. At this point, what's more important, discussing the call or getting set to be able to rotate to the shooting spot?
That's exactly right. He should be talking to his teammates right now. There's nothing the ref can do to help him. And A&M will probe from X again. They seem to really like this two-on-one they have on this back corner.
See, that was obviously that shot wasn't – it didn't get the mark, but it was the three-quarter bounce. Connolly was already low, and it jumped up. You know, I really like that look. Oh, I just don't
look
like
inside.
That look at all, though.
And A&M's seems to be, you know, their success rides on how patient they are on offense. When they just force an early look, it's getting eaten up every single time.
If you're going to – so initially right now, A&M has had – or SMU has had a tough time rotating on the man down. So if they've had a tough time and they make the initial rotation, well, let's attack the end of the rotation.
That's right. Let's keep it moving. If they have trouble making that first rotation, the fourth or the fifth are going to be real tough. And A&M looking to pressure out a little bit here.
Yep, they're still it's 6-on-6 now. Need to get a one slide to this big boy.
You're exactly right.
Forced him to his left hand. I would do that pretty much every single time moving forward.
And A&M seems to really trust their one-on-one defense. If you look at the adjacent defenders, they're pressed out pretty far.
Carrying hard up from X. You better finish that play.
And that's a tough call for the referee to make. The guy's falling down. Either he tripped or he got pushed. It's hard to tell.
SMU going uppers. 9-8, A&M holding on to it.
And both of these teams have spent a good amount of time in the box, so we might find that man-up efficiency is one of the big keys to who's going to win this game today.
Agreed. Here we go. They scored their last time. They got them to rotate. Now they've got the skip. They got them
the
really
they
moving.
Want and a great shot.
That's number 11.
Looked like Marco Robertson dropped a little bit when he dropped his stick, and he was able to get it to that top corner. Great finish there.
That guy's stepping in. Goalie's shrinking, giving up surface area, and then he popped it up top.
That's fine. So we're all tied up again, and the onus is on the faceoff X.
Here they go. They got them hip to hip right here. Robertson wins it.
And just like you said, we had a pull on the faceoff this time. Looks like they're trying to get a little more pressure on that faceoff, man. A little advantage.
Whammy.
Oh! Great fake and great finish.
That's Cameron Doan. Cameron Doan gives SMU the lead with 7:31 in the third quarter. That's how you fake your way to the middle, right? You're carrying hard downhill. You throw a box fake to freeze that adjacent man. Now you've faked your way all the way into the middle.
And that's exactly right. If you don't draw the man, you might as well keep going and get a good look. And this adjustment on the faceoff looks to be really paying off for SMU. They're creating some chaos in there. They got a loose ball push on that one. Same thing. Going to have to give them 5 yards off of that.
What a bad penalty.
And give credit for A&M for picking up the ball and being ready to go.
They keep the ball in, too.
Mismatch at X.
Tip, it's done. Yeah. Blow it. Nobody has to pick it up. Ten to nine. Ponies galloping back to take the lead here. Will they be able to build on it? This has been their largest lead of the game. One goal. A&M has dictated possession. SMU has been efficient with their offensive output. Roughly a million penalties in this game. A&M going uppers. We'll see how it plays out.
And that's exactly right. It seems like any time it looks like one team's really getting the momentum about to pull away, they end up with a man down in the box. A&M looking to be a little more patient on this one. Look like we've got a little more of a set play. Hopping into the 1-3-2. Oh, and they did not get
no
back
way.
Up on that,
that
one.
Is so bad.
That's a tough call right there.
That's really tough.
The Aggie faithful not happy about that one. Caleb Brooks taking it upon himself to kill this penalty all alone. Looks like A&M will not elect a double team. And we're
that was
all
big.
Even.
That was big. That's another failed. That's another failed man up opportunity for A&M. That was huge.
Got a break going the other way. He's got a man wide open if he looks. Oh!
Don't fade.
There's no way they missed this one. All right.
You just can't fade there.
Really can, especially if you're going to be cherry picking. You got to finish.
You got to get underneath, inside that guy's line. Banana under. But again, A&M's getting their opportunities. It's just going to be a function of finishing at this point. They're getting tons of shots. Tons of shots. They just need more of them to fall. At the end of the first half, I believe the shooting was 24 shots for A&M, 15. That's a nice little staggered screen. Let's see what the shots were in the first half and what it is now. That's a good job just jumping that. Here we go. They're ready to dodge the backside. Here's Bryce Green being guarded by a long stick again.
He
makes
looks
sense.
Like he likes this matchup. Oh, great
oh
feed on the inside.
Oh, my goodness.
There was not a lot of space there, but he found it.
That's Michael Bryan from Bryce Green. So what happened there was Michael Bryan. Sorry, we're keeping tabs here. Bryce Green leaning on his man. They don't like that matchup. They look to go. They go from the crease. They pull their slide instead of pushing their slide, so they're late. Give up a ball side cut. Just a fraction of a second late, and Brian's able to finish that.
And Bryce Green's really putting a lot of pressure on the defense with that bulldog right there because they're not really sure when to slide. He's got his man right on his hip. He's still a threat to score. So it's really tough to know when you should go. And as soon as they did, as soon as they backed off that crease just a little bit, he put one on the inside and made him pay for it.
Big face-off win there by the Fighting Texas Aggies. Aggies get the ball. Now, this is where they really have to do a good job of applying pressure. If they can get a finish here, if they can convert or even just withstand a long possession, you know, we'll see what happens.
Well, and if you look, SMU's not really flying out to the ball as much as they were in the first half, and it's interesting to know if that's a function of fatigue or maybe they made an adjustment and they want to put the onus on the Aggies to make the decisions. Great deflection by the defender.
Got to turn him.